I won't lie to you. I know he's just not right for you.
Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Tulu Lokwe and it is so good to be here again. If this is your first time of tuning in, please do subscribe. I post videos about lifestyle, marriage, beauty, my faith, and a range of other good stuff. So today, as the title indicates, I'm talking about 6 signs that man is not the one for you. When I say he's not the one for you, I'm saying, you know, he's not the one you should date, he's not the one you should be in a relationship with, he's not the one you should marry. So let's jump right into it. The first thing is, he's a married man. Now, the Bible is pretty clear on this one. It says, what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. I don't know how somebody in their right sense, I don't know if it's because of money or, you know, you will now say, oh, I want to date a man that is married. Now, if a man was married and maybe he's now separated, but he's yet to finalize his divorce, he's still married. You know, let that man be through with his baggage before he brings you in. You know, even if he's a good man, he has to finish up with his former life, for lack of a better word, before bringing you on board. The second point is, he's abusive or disrespectful. Now, this part is really important to me because I don't know how somebody will claim to love you and beat you and hit you and slap you and you're still choosing to be in a relationship with that person. Why? Why? I don't understand this particular one. It's in two parts. There's physical abuse and there is emotional abuse. Physical abuse is too obvious for you to stay. Like I said, if a man is hitting you, then that is a pointer. Because trust me, if he hits you now, he will kill you in marriage. It's not going to stop. I feel like violence is a spirit, and once a man has it, it's going to be so difficult. So except you want to really sign on for suffered, for lack of better word, you want to sign on for a man to be beating you all days of your life, then this is the best time for you to run. Now, the second part, which is emotional abuse, this is very, I don't know the word to use. Let me see. It's undefined, you know. People say, I don't know if he's really, I don't even know. A man talks to you anyhow, calls you names, insults you, says you're of no good, you know, collects your money, refuses to pay back, and he's still insulting you on top of that. Now, that is emotional abuse. Emotional abuse is simple. Anything that drains you emotionally. This is not you fighting with your man. Some of us are super emotional, you know, and even day-to-day fights can seem draining. But I'm talking about, like, on a bigger scale, things that drain you. Anything that makes you lose your self-respect, your self-esteem, and your self-worth is emotional abuse. And you shouldn't be in that relationship. You deserve to be in a better relationship than a man who will make you feel less of a woman or less of yourself. So, yeah. That's pretty clear. Just put your 2 shoes on your head and
run.
The third thing is, this man is selfish or he's unable to compromise. Now, the good part about this one is, you know, you can still talk to him about it. Let him know, oh, I feel like I'm the one always giving my time, my airtime, pun intended, my resources, my emotions, everything in this relationship is all about me. I'm always the one giving. You're just there, you receive gifts, you receive money, you receive everything. This is discussable, for a lack of better word as well. But, you know, if it's a trait, a year's past, and this man still doesn't put effort into your relationship, I don't know how you claim to love somebody and you can be selfish. Now, there are levels to this. Some people are like lavish givers. And I'm not saying every man has to be lavish with gifts or, but you will know if a man is selfish. If a man has a job he doesn't like, for instance, he will still dress up and go to that work. Not to talk of you that he likes and he cannot even pick up the phone, a day has passed and he hasn't called you. No, it doesn't work like that. If a man is just too self-involved, it is a sign to run. Everything has to revolve around him. You know, you have to carry his leg, carry his head, carry his hand. No. We are women, yeah, and we should even be the ones to be pampered. That is not an excuse for a woman to be selfish, though. There are also selfish women, and that is wrong on every level. Marriage is sweet when two givers come together. I mean, the overflow is amazing. It is the best thing in this world. After Jesus, you know, if a man is so self-involved, everything is all about him, no, you should run. After talking to him, after enduring, he might be a good man. That's the tricky part about this. He might be good to you, but I actually don't even see how a man can be good without giving. No, scrap that. I said it might be good to you. If a man doesn't give, and when I talk about giving, I'm talking about giving resources, giving time, giving attention, giving emotions and all of that. If he's not giving, then I don't see how he can, you know, be a good person to you. Then the fourth thing, which I'll touch on very briefly, is flirty. You've gone on the first date, and while you're there, is looking at somebody's bum bum that is walking past. Let it go. You're going on second date, and then his phone happens to be upward faced, and then you see a text from somebody, a nude picture. And the third time again, you mistakenly find yourself inside his DM. You're reading through his messages, and you're seeing that he's so everywhere, talking to this girl, talking to that girl. Just like violence, in my opinion. I feel like infidelity is a spirit, and once a man has it, it takes spiritual intervention for it to really go away. So except you're ready to put up with the drama that comes with trust, the drama that comes with baby mama, the drama that comes with a flirty husband, then you want to run. Especially if you're sensing the grace of God upon your life and you know that you want to really go far, then you should not be involved with a man like that. That is just my best advice for you. The fifth point is that this man doesn't fear anybody. He's a danger on two legs, ready to explode. And by the time he explodes, it's going to be only you that will be there, because there's nobody else he fears. I don't know how somebody doesn't have somebody he's answerable to. Not his father, not his mother, not his mentor, not any friend that, you know, somebody he even looks up to, or somebody he respects. And even if you guys have issues, you can say, oh, I'm going to report you to this person, and that will keep him on his toes. His pastor, his imam, nobody. And that is not good enough. I feel like everybody should have a sort of authority over themselves to just keep them in check. If you don't trust anybody else, then your dad or your mom. In the absence of that, like if you don't happen to have any of those, then you need to find a mentor. A guy has to have somebody who is answerable to. And this person doesn't even have to know about the details of your marriage or relationship, but that way, you know, there's somebody who keeps him on his toes in case he's deviating, in case you need to report him to somebody. You know, there's somebody he fears. Basically, there has to be. Then the sixth point, and the last point, which is very similar to the fifth point, is that he doesn't have a value system. He doesn't have a belief system. He's not a Christian. He's not a Muslim. There is nothing he believes in. Basically, that's bad. If you're a Christian, then that would mean you're even being unequally yoked with an unbeliever or somebody who doesn't believe in God and all of that. But you know, I know that people from different religions watch me, so I would just say, if he doesn't have a belief system. Now this is bad, because as human beings, there is somewhere we get our source of strength from. There is a belief that keeps you on your toes. You know, there is a force behind you, there is a strength that keeps you on your toes. And if you don't have any of that, then who is he really? That will say a lot about the kind of person he is. That would make you want to ask questions about what he's living for. Exactly, yes. So with those six things, I hope I have been able to drop one or two hints. I have to say, I'm not a shrink, I'm not a love doctor, I'm not a preacher, but you know, these are even pretty obvious things we see every day, but for some reasons we women still find ourselves in these messed up situations that we see, and we still decide to go through it, and then it becomes a problem at the end of the day. So yeah, I hope you have learned a thing or two. Thank you so much if you stayed to the end, and I'll see you in my next video. God bless you. Bye. And you could tell me if I'm off, but I see it on your face when you say videos. And you spending all your time. My name is Tulu Lokwe. If this is your first and anytime you want it to stop. I know I can treat you better than he can, and any girl like you.